I will be teaching about the topic tympanic membrane perforation, or call it as TMP. And this topic is for BSc third year. So first, before going into the disease condition, first let us see what is tympanic membrane, or we also call it as eardrum. Okay, so tympanic membrane or eardrum, it is an oval, semi-transparent. Okay, so you can see here, this is like an oval shape. Shape of an egg. Okay, it is semi-transparent. Okay, you can see here also it is a little bit transparent, pearly gray, tri-laminar membrane, and it separates the middle ear from the external ear. Okay, so this tympanic membrane, it lies where? It lies between the middle ear and the external ear, and it also separates the two portions of the ear. That is, it separates the middle ear and it separates from the external ear from those two. Now the measurements. So let us see what are the measurements of tympanic membrane or the eardrum. How much is the length or how much is the diameter? So measurements are 9 to 10 millimeter in diameter. That is the maximum. Okay, that is the maximum length. And 8 to 9 millimeter diameter, this is the minimum length. Okay, so these are some of the measurements of tympanic membrane or measurements of eardrum. Now let us see what is the position, where is it being placed. It is placed obliquely 55 degree angle with floor of external acoustic meatus. Okay, so it is placed oblique, it is not straight. Okay, so it is oblique. At what angle? 55 degree angle with the floor of the external acoustic meatus. And it is newborn. In newborn, it is horizontal. Okay, so in newborn, it is placed in the horizontal position, whereas in adults, it is oblique. Okay, so that is the position. The measurements is 9 to 10 millimeter diameter maximum and 8 to 9 millimeter diameter minimum. And where is it placed? It separates the middle ear and it separates the middle ear from the external ear. And it is an oval, semi-transparent, pearly gray, trilaminar membrane. Okay, so this is about the tympanic membrane. So let us see what is tympanic membrane perforation. So what do you mean by perforation? Perforation means to make holes. Okay, kisi cheez ka patna. Okay, to make a hole or to make a chhed in a place. So that is perforation. So tympanic membrane perforation means a hole in the eardrum. Okay, or a hole in the tympanic membrane. So tympanic membrane perforation, it is defined as a condition of rupture or perforation of the eardrum, meaning that there is a hole in the eardrum. Okay, so that is the meaning of tympanic membrane perforation. So you can see this is another definition. Eardrum is ruptured in one or both the ears. So eardrum can be in both the ears, or it can be in only one ear. Okay, so this is a normal tympanic membrane. You can see it is oval in shape, it is semi-transparent, okay, gray, pearly gray in color. Okay, now you can see this is perforated tympanic membrane. So you can see there is a hole, okay, that is being perforated. Okay, so this hole here, this perforation, so this is called tympanic membrane perforation. You can see here also, okay, so this is a normal, and you can see the perforated tympanic membrane. You can see the malleus, the incus, okay, and this is the, you can see this hole here. So this is the ruptured tympanic membrane. So what are the causes of this hole, or what are the causes for this perforation in the tympanic membrane or in the eardrum? Okay, so first is because of any direct force. So direct force can be careless while removing wax by himself or herself. Okay, so some people, they try to take out their, try to clean their ears or try to take out the ear wax, or call it a cerumen, by their own fingers, or, by inserting a, a, a clip or inserting a safety pin inside or by using a matchstick. Okay, they are not using proper earbuds. So because of this, any careless mistake inside, okay, too much of force they are giving inside into the ears while cleaning, so that can lead to perforation, or that can lead to the formation of hole in the eardrum. Next, skull fracture may tear the tympanic membrane. Okay, any fracture, okay, skull fracture especially, that can cause tympanic membrane. Next, a hot flag fly into the ear, meaning that in any flies, okay, it can be a bee or it can be house flies, or it can be any insect. Okay, when they enter into your ear, then it can cause tympanic membrane perforation. So that is a direct force. So coming next is the indirect force. Indirect force means indirectly. Okay, any force which has been given into the ears, okay, on especially on the tympanic membrane indirectly, then it is one of the cause. So first is increase in violence and firearm. Okay, increase in violence. Suppose there's any fight or a boxing match or any fight between two or three people. So the other person may put a blow on your ears. So that can lead to formation of holes in the eardrum or the tympanic membrane. And firearms also and barotrauma. Okay, barotrauma is the pressure. Okay, so because of too much of pressure also, it can cause perforation in the tympanic membrane. So you can see here, okay, so this is a tympanic membrane, or we call it as eardrum. So it, you know, what does it do? It separates the middle ear from the external ear. So that is the main function of the tympanic membrane. Now, what are the causes of the other causes of tympanic membrane are foreign bodies, usually pointed objects. So, like I said, you know, people tend to insert keys or insert pencil, or they try to insert matchstick or safety pins or any hair clip into the ears, okay, to clean out their wax. So, because of that also, it can cause tympanic membrane perforation. Then any infection of the middle ear can cause rupture of the eardrum. The infection can be caused by bacteria or virus or fungi. Next, trauma, any trauma to the eardrum and it causes pain. Next, clinical manifestation. So what are the signs and symptoms? First is otalgia, pain in the eardrum, pain in the ears. Next, patient will have fullness, discomfort, blood tinge discharge from the ear because of the hole formation. There is perforation, so there will be bleeding. Next, hearing loss, which is conductive hearing loss or mixed hearing loss. And patient will have vertigo and tinnitus, which is the ringing sensation in the ears. So that is called tinnitus. So these are some of the signs and symptoms of tympanic membrane perforation. So there are some complications which are associated with tympanic membrane perforation, and these are as follows. Ossicular discontinuity, meaning that if there's any disruption in the ossicles, okay, it can be in the it can be in the stapes or in the malleus. So if this because of the perforation of the tympanic membrane, because of the hole formation, therefore it can cause disruption, or it will the ossicles will not function properly. Next, facial nerve injury. Okay, it can also cause facial nerve injury. Next, caudate tympani nerve injury and barotrauma to the stapes foot plate. Okay, so these are some of the complications which are associated with tympanic membrane perforation. So that is why treatment of or surgical management of tympanic membrane perforation should be treated so as to avoid these complications. Next, diagnostic evaluation or test. First, history collection should be taken. Physical examination should be done. Otoscopic examination, okay, to visualize the internal ears. Then tympanogram. Okay, so tympanogram is basically a test which is used to to see the movement of the tympanic membrane. Okay. So tympanic, one second. So the tympanogram. Okay, it is the examination which is used to test the condition of the middle ear, and it used to check the mobility, that is the function of the eardrum, or to check the function of the tympanic membrane. So that is the tympanogram. Next, audiogram or audio test. So this is done to check the audibility of the patient, okay, whether the patient is able to hear properly or not. So these are some of the diagnostic tests that we can perform on a patient. Next, coming to the management, medical management. So first, because of infection, we will give antibiotic therapy, aseptic external auditory canal with alcohol, prevent super respiratory infection, prohibit the nasal blow, okay, avoid, tell the patient not to blow their nose forcefully. Next, prohibit eardrops, okay, for some time you do not instill any eardrops into the ears, affected ear. It takes 3 to 4 weeks to heal the eardrum. If 3 months later perforation still exists, then we can go for surgical management, that is meningoplasty. So these are some of the managements, okay, that we can perform on the patient. Now coming to the surgical management. So in surgical management, we have tympanoplasty, which is the surgical correction of the perforated tympanic membrane. Okay, so tympanoplasty is mainly done to correct, or if there's any hole, if there's a hole in the tympanic membrane, then this surgical management will try to reconstruct or to correct the hole formation. Okay, so this is performed under local anesthesia. An incision will be made behind the ear or entirely through the ear canal, and depending on the location and the size of the tympanic membrane perforation. So it depends on the size. How much is the hole? It is a small hole, or it is a big hole, or where is the size? Okay, where is the location? So the incision will be made behind the ears mostly, or through the ear canal. So this is tympanoplasty. Okay, this is the first surgical management. Next, coming to the second management is meningoplasty, which is the closure of perforation. Okay, closing all the holes, okay, that is called meningoplasty. Next, auriculoplasty, it is the auricular reconstruction. Okay, so we will try to reconstruct the ossicles, okay, the incus, the stapes, and the malleus. Okay, because because of tympanic membrane perforation, there will be disruption in the ossicles. Okay, so if there's any disruption in the ossicles, that is the incus, the stapes, or the malleus, then we will perform an auriculoplasty. Okay, we will try to reconstruct the bones. Okay, the 3 bones, we will try to reconstruct them and try to make them function normally. Now coming to, so those were the 3 surgical managements. Okay, now coming to the prevention. First, we have to treat the ear infection. Okay. As early as possible, we will try to give antibiotics to reduce the infection rate. Next, protect against any excessive noise. Okay, so you can wear those ear cuffs, or you can wear those, we can put any ear pads so that to prevent any excessive noise. And avoid any any loud music, and air protective during air travel. So when you have to travel by airplane also, we will have to protect our ears, therefore to avoid any further complications. So this is about the tympanic membrane perforation. So I hope this is clear about this topic. We have come to the end of the topic for today. Okay, so thank you, class.